OK, the last review of Record After Cultures 2021, and that is Star Wars themselves, which I was missing for. So, let's do it. Record Star Wars Certified 307, Star Wars After Cultures have 325 pieces at retail, a 40 bucks on USA and 20 bucks on other retailers as well. So let's take a look at the box first. On the front side, looks pretty good. It has an absolutely good detail of the snow. And Christmas version of the Russell Press is one of the best part about the front side of the box. We cover some rainbow light design plus snowflake and of course corn as well. I also love the dated red color scheme to green on the bow side. It fits much better than we already have in a true tie. And if it would be too tight on this one, then it will probably feel like overusing of them. But thank goodness they did, and because this we actually get what we have. So thank you so much, Rico. And on the sides of these box, on the upside, it has the Metroidian Mythicals on the Mythicals flame all sides. At the back side of the box, it's show up, you can update the auto date as well, and you can collect or build and all Mythicals as well, just like what show up in a tree mini build and tree. I mean, just like what the back side show up, it has a D6 mini build that already opened and tree Mythicals as well. By the way, it has Disney logos as well, plus the logos and titles of RocketCon's Star Wars as well. On every side we play Disney one. So yeah, so now let's actually cut this tape from the cap one. So here with a knife, I can use it and cut these two tape on the back side. And there it comes. So inside of the box, the design of inside here, which is of the wall, looks really good. It's not as good as the pieces one, which is rather the best one of the flat sides, but still have really detail here. Well, the tower size is pretty blind looking because just few to this side. This side is the detail, and that's why it's at least there are a good damage snow fix plus rainbow light that gives something good think about the dark size. So yeah, but anyway, so now let's actually update the day number one of Record Star Wars. So let's update the day number one, which is right here. And that is a nano 81st new build. Just like some after characters, sometimes me figures first, sometimes me builds first. At this day, which is this after characters, me builds first. Okay, now day number two, which is right here. And yep, what I get, and now me build. So now, day number three. And about time, any figures. Now day number four. It's a mini build. So now on day number five. It has, but again a mini build. So now on day number six. At what I get a mini build. So now on day number seven. But I get a mini build. So now on day number eight. It's about time, and of course about time another mini figures. Now of course the next day. So the next day number nine. Ed, yep, it's ain't gonna be you. I mean, be your turn. Be your turn, sorry about. But again, yep, it ain't gonna be built. Yep, hey, what again? A Mimi built. Me built and me built. That's about it. Now, sorry, now on day number 10. Yep, but again, me built. Now on day number 11. And yep, but again, me built. So now on day number, day number 12. And yep, but again, me built. Okay, so now on day number 13. And yep, and told me figures about time. So now on day number 14. And yep, it's a nanometer built. So now on day number 15. Yep, it's a nanometer built. So now on day number 16. Hey, what's I get here? A meter built. So now on day number 17. And yep, it's a nanometer built. Now on day number 80. And yep, it's a Timmy figures, aka bricks built figures. So yeah. So now on day number 90. And yep, it's a Nanami built. Now on day number 12. Yep, it's a nanometer figures. Now day on 21. And yep, it's a nanometer built. Now day on 22. And yep, it's of course a nanometer figures, aka a baby figures, by the way. Now on day 23. Yep, this one must be the last me built, so yeah. So now the last day, day number 24. And that means, there we come. Yep, the me figures themselves. So day number one is the Razzle Crest, which is they don't need other than since we only have of the busy day, busy after cultures, but it still makes sense that this after cultures is definitely the method of the place on the Star Wars The Mandalorian TV series that it was already over on the last years. So it makes sense to have it there. It's still cute looking, it have some design cards actually update to have the actual the accurate of the original fossil of the Razzle Crest with Faker Summit here. And then the day number 2 is actually Instafix, and that is World Modern Star Fighter themselves, which is based off the Metroid as well. And the design of them looks pretty good, yet it seems a little bit inaccurate of the G series as well, which they could have done way better with something else. And then day number 3 is a Stormtrooper, which I already mentioned on the 2009 G sets plus I don't remember how much the other set was, so many, I'm just something forgetting about it. I don't know how much of this yet. Hey, microfibers. Yeah, microfibers. And there is also a pair of 4 plus eight rings start finder as well. And yeah, that's all it. Nothing else about it. Nothing else to say about this day tree. It also appeared on 2020 after characters from across the last years of Star Wars after characters as well. I totally forgot that. Which is, yeah, we already have one as well. But it's what I get based on the Mandalorian TV series, so yeah. But they could at least replace a black stormtrooper of many stormtrooper pilots of Tide Fighter as well. Since we already have stormtrooper of the last years of Rocket Star Wars after Kaltos EU. So day number 4 is it's F-Web Heavy Blaster Snove. At the side of them is the actually remake for the of the 2040 a heavy blaster snow floor because Star Wars after Kaltos 2040. Which is actually nice little AD update fix. At the side of them it's alright. Not too special here, but I do like it how starts here. That we don't get a new one, we have a lot of good quality, so yeah. And then number 5 it's such a trainic targets, so yeah. At the side of them, yeah, I never too much to say, they're all pointless. So yeah, so these trainic targets is definitely the pointless build, so yeah. So day number 6 is a Imperial Troop transport, which the side of them is definitely looks much better than 2081. I really love feel like Imperial Troop transport, except micro scale of them. And I really love how this side looks like as well. The only problem I have is having the red color scheme that it sticks out so badly. But still a really good build. On day number 7, it's a LED Speedol, which is definitely the base of the Mandalorian, not look LED Speedol themselves. Its design of LED Speedol looks really good. It has a new recall scheme with a light blue, and some parts like on the doors looks a little bit different as well. It also have only one slope pizza instead of two, which is absolutely the best choice to do it this. It's because of that, it feels like the upgrade of the TV series as well, but sometimes not, so yeah, but still a really good build. Day number 8 is a Toolskate Barrator, which is the same design as 2020, which you can actually collect the army of Toolskin Rider as well, just like the Stormtrooper. Day number 9 is Toolskin Rider Rapid Wrecked, which they look pretty much a basic, not too much to say, so yeah. Day number 10 is Toolskin Rider Snow Launcher, which is definitely based on the written Toolskin Rider Ball Launcher for the Trouble on that, which is the base of the original fossil of Trouble on Daytona set for Star Wars Winter 2021 set, which is definitely nice, including as PID micro scale, and the side of them looks really good. Still have the blaster pieces, which, but again, we see them in this last year's set. In 2022, we get the new one, we can have it better quality, so yeah. And then, day number 11 is X-Wing Starfighter. And this eye is the same as the older Lego Star Wars After Kratos,
bullshit! Absolute bullshit! It's the same way as the older Afrikaners who have the same dislike as what this set have. Gosh, this is so sickening.
Day number 20 is Dietfighter themselves. A dislike of them looks really good. It looks like the mixed force of 2040 Microscale Dietfighter, I mean Dietfighter, and Microscale Force Order Dietfighter as well, between Belt and Tikolsky. I mean, love the dictated white Kolsky with Trice Black. It works very well. It's definitely feel like the actual upgrade of the original Dietfighter set. So I really appreciate that. It definitely did a good job of them as well. So, really good build. So, day number 20 is a Scout Trooper, which is a detailed appeal of this guy set. He only appear on the horrendous ever converted Axe attack, I mean Axe battle, and the Razor Crest from the last years as well. Which you can actually collect this kind on your collection of Skull Troopers as here the only me figures. Day number 40 is Imperia Rapid Wrecked. A design of them looks alright. Not too special. It's half lucky detail, but I still like it. sorry, it's half a rapid heal, so I do appreciate that. So yeah. Day number 50 is Speedol Bike. A design of them looks really good. It's a little bit bigger than the 2021. It has, and of course, it has said that you can sit Skull Troopers me figures, which is definitely the upgrade of the 2020 Skull Troopers fin set on the Speedo Bikes from the Star Wars After Encounters 2021. It's definitely great reference, which is definitely great reference what I ever see this. And what the funniest thing is that it's a white Speedo bike with a black Skull Troopers. So in the 2022 a Stormtrooper battle pack, it have a white Skull Troopers on him white Speedo bike. Yeah, that's actually really hilarious. Generally what I constantly thought. Next is a day number 60 is Noble Curry. At the sake of them, it's kind of bland, okay? But I don't like the me droid build, but it's half here, so I really like that. And day number 70 is Imperial Light Scroll Sword. At the sake of them, looks really good. It definitely feel like the upgrade of the original version of Imperial Light Scrolls, except have a really adorable Loki and have some good builds as well. However, some type could be floppy like this build, which is a top size, so yeah. And then day number 80 is, and then of course the day number, sorry. And then day number 80 is it's all iterate gold droid. At the side of that, it's definitely cute. It's still the same as the older. Interrogator droid. But again, interrogator droid. Figures build. Except the only difference with older it's all interrogator droid is that he have actually Seracate pieces on the left one, which makes a little bit different here. It still looks absolutely adorable here as well. On day number 90 is it's Boba Fett Starship, aka Slave One. Yeah, it seems Slave One was also all those names as well. So they designed the names of Boba Fett Starship, which on this level what they changed, but still no excuse to change this as much like Kevin Kaufman currently be president of Lucasfilms. But anyway, the design of them looks really nice. It have the better wigs about Titan the original one, Belkorsky, and have really same feelings as the 2021 for the summer wave, which is like Boba Fett, Star Seven set. But even more slick than fun, so it's a mini build, so it's always fun to play with. Plus, the wig still can move me very well, so never too much to say about it. And then the day, 12 is Iggy 11. And this is the character who also appeared on the last years of the Star Wars with the Rise of Crest, which is now appeared on the cheapest one. And the design of AG-11 looks really good. It's not too much to say, but what makes really good is the face printing. It's really great looking if you like the average of the TV series, which I really love. And it has the back size, which is one stat that I am not sure of. So yeah, it still have a dark grey color scheme, which fits very well as the average of the TV series one, which I really like it. Day number 21 is Metal Warrior Rabbit Rex. And the design of them looks absolutely way better than the Imperial Rabbit Rex. I really like it, at least has some detail here and there. It has some rabbits for Metal Warrior as well, that I really like it. For day number 22 is Grover D. Todd Festival outfit. And the side of that looks really cute. It has like the Christmas portrait of the Grogu, which have a really good pretty design here that I really like it. And it also has like his the baby Yoda holder pieces that you can put it on the bike, speed of bike, and mostly on Metal Warrior as well, that I really like it. So definitely really good day of this guy's plot is still adorable and the head is pretty much the same. So yeah, and still a really adorable figures, again me figures and baby figures in general. And then the day 23, which is the last build of Record Star Wars after Countdown 2021 is Grogu Hoverboard Prime themselves, which is the Christmas version of Grogu Hoverboard Prime built themselves. And I think it actually appeared on Imperial Light Crusher. And the side of that looks really good. It has a different color scheme with light gray and red as well. In the original one, it have a white and yellow, which it makes sense they chose dark light gray instead of white, because we cover white, not too much say, but the same as the original one, except have a yellow instead of red, which it makes feel like the company likes them, and we cover the place with light gray, which it still fits very well. We cover light gray and red be the Christmas faucet of Grogu Hoverbrand build. And then the last day, which is day number 4, day number 24, the last minifigures, which is the Daily Metron, again Metal Warrior, with a festival outfit themselves. And the cycle of them looks like a written design of Metal Warrior, aka the DIY Mentor design themselves. And that's the guys who reveal of the face still have the black and me figures to do reveal of the face was actually the plot themselves. The only difference with a written one is have a Christmas scarf, which is definitely not included of these me figures, which I really like it having them. It looks really good of these car locks and fits really well. And yeah, because it's a normal outfit with covered Christmas scarf, this is basically the weakest me figures because we cover the same design but have a Christmas scarf, and that's about it. Now I said nothing else about it. So I guess that's about it. All the feel of all 24 days of Record Star Wars after Kratos. So overall, this After Countdown was actually good. It's a mostly good build, but sometimes were kind of bland. Not as bland as Record Bobo After Countdown, but still some of them true blood, but mostly built on really good. We get a really good Boba Fett starfighter build, of course, on light speeder, the Razor Crest, the new vehicles, TIE Fighter, Red Rapids, hover prep for Grover, speeder bike, and other build I do like it as well. Only clinic target at X-Wing Starfighter is really bad day. And of course with a snow curry is just the bland one. Same goes for Imperia Rapid Red as well. So yeah. And by the way, A-Web Heavy Blaster Snow is basically alright. So yeah. The minifigure is kinda see a little bit weak. Like, we already have Stormtroopers from the DBC's Years of After Characters of Ruckus Towers. The Skull Radio is definitely the same, with also a bit of the older 20 box plus 20 box set as well, so I need it. And the Christmas version of Metroid, which is again the Gallery Mentor, is pretty much the requirement. We can't have the same design. Just give the Christmas card and that's it. The only minifigures was worth it is the Black Skull Trooper set. It still have really fantastic design that still people wanna collect them as get the only minifigures of Skull Troopers. IG-11 is actually only a build of the Razor Crest, which he actually a build in the second time of this 40 bucks on USA and 20 bucks on Honor Legends after characters, which is now cheaper to get discounts on this price, which is one floor USA, which is not so cheaper and kinda expensive, and 20 bucks on Honor on Etocos, which is a 40 bucks, and 20 bucks for older letters, a little bit cheaper here. At the Christmas version of Baby Yoda, again, rather detailed, it's just a normal as I remember. So, yeah. So, this is basically a really good after characters of Record Star Wars. Harry Potter is still the best one of this year's. City is definitely the great one, Star Wars is good, and Marvel is just a disappointment here. So as a whole, I recommend this, but I mostly recommend it for global detailed with a festival outfit, IG-11, and Black Skull Troopers as well, plus some of them the Mi build as well in general, like the Razor Cross, those Kami builds, Speedo build, Tide Fighters, Imperial Light Cruiser, and Boba Fett Starship, and of course Imperial Drops Transport, which by the way is really good build, and even the new vehicles of the After Gardens, which is Right Mare Starfighters as well, that I really like. So I guess that's about it. And as a whole, I give it a, I give it a 7/9 out of 10. Yep, what again, 7/9 out of 10. So, what you guys think is, I guess I have all done review of all four of local After Characters 2021. We'll actually see them in the next years. And link comment below, this is actually actually really good after characters of this year's except for Marvel one. But anyway, so what you guys think is, like, comment it below. This is Sparkle Time and sign out.